You have made the majority of your revisions, and now you are ready for some formatting and just putting the final touches for MLA style. A quick note about utilizing this video, you need to pause along the way in order to follow each step. Do not wait until the video is done and then try to do the entire thing from memory, please. You must complete each step that is being addressed. None of these are optional. And if something goes too fast, just obviously rewind and rewatch before you just give up and try to ask for help. Okay, the first thing we're going to talk about is adding an MLA style header. The header on this page is what is in the upper left-hand corner. And the way it goes for MLA is that it's your name, your instructor's name, the name of your course, and the date. Notice the date is written in the formal style. So it says 5 February 2016 with no comma. And that is the way it needs to be done in this case. So at this point, you can pause the video and go ahead and do this on your rough draft. The next thing we need to talk about is adding a title. Because this is a research paper that is argumentative, we are not going to want a creative or cute title because that won't fit the purpose or the audience of this paper. Your title needs to be concise, which means to the point. And obviously it should inform readers of the paper's content, just like most nonfiction titles do. So examples of acceptable titles include Why the Red Cross Deserves Support, or The Red Cross, colon, a charity worthy of support. Most of your titles will follow those two examples. There are probably a couple others that would be acceptable, but not many. You can pause the video again and go ahead and do that title. All right, this part is going to be very multi-step. You're going to want to really pay attention here. We need to add your works cited page to the last part of your paper. Yes, you've been doing in-text citations or parenthetical citations, but those are not the full citations. In-text citations are just shortcuts that lead your reader to the real citation, which is listed in your bibliography or what we call the works cited page. So here's how to do that. The first thing that you're going to want to do is go into Noodle Tools to your bibliography section where you're going to see all of your citations here. And then over here where it says print export, there's a little arrow. When you click on that, there is an option that says print export to Google Docs. Sometimes it's going to ask you to choose your account depending on whether you're signed into another account. And then this process right here sometimes takes forever. And you just have to be patient, and finally it opens up into a Word document, and it even gave it its own name. One thing I want to point out is that it has a title. It's being called Works Cited. That is going to need to stay there. Each of my citations take up two lines just because it's too long to fit over here. And you can see that the second part of the citation is indented. So this is the whole first citation. This is called a hanging indent. Well, now I have a problem because this is on one document, but my rough draft is over here on this other document. So pay attention. I'm going to select all of this and copy. So that for me was Control C. And I'm coming back to my rough draft and I'm going to scroll all the way down to the very last part of my paper. And as you can see, my paper ends in the middle of a page here. It doesn't go all the way down to the bottom. But my works cited page, which I'm about to paste here, can't just be right here. I need to just enter, or go into insert page break. However you want to do that, you need to get it onto its own last page. So now that I'm on the very, very last fresh page, I'm going to paste it here. And I'm going to leave all of the formatting. So don't mess around with things and backspace anything. This is exactly how it should look. You might notice that my font styles are now different because this is Arial up here and Times New Roman down here. In just a moment, I'm going to fix that, so hang tight. You can pause the video and do these steps right now. Now that you're done putting your Works Cited page onto the end of your document, we need to start talking about the font and format specs. These are very specific for MLA, and there are a lot listed here. I'm going to tell you about them now, and then I'm going to give you examples of how to make this happen on your Google Doc. The font size must be size 12. Google's default is size 11, so pay attention to that. The font needs to be either Arial or Times New Roman, and it can't be a little bit of both. You have to have consistency throughout your whole paper. You need to have black ink as the color. The paper must be double spaced, and if you don't know how to do that or what that means, you'll see in a moment. If you haven't messed with the margins, then you're probably fine, but it needs to have 1-inch margins on the left, the right, the top, and the bottom. But if you haven't messed with them, then they already are 1-inch margins. You also need to only use one space after periods. For most of you, you do that naturally. Some people have been taught to hit the space bar twice at the end of every sentence, and for MLA, that is incorrect. You cannot have extra spaces between paragraphs where you hit the enter button several times, and I'll show you what I mean by that. And every time you need a new paragraph, and so you need to indent, that must be used by the tab key versus hitting the space bar 5 or 6 times. If I go into my rough draft here, the first thing I notice is that I'm in Arial size 11, but remember, my Works Cited is size 12 Times New Roman. So what I'm going to do is select all. So that's just Control A. And I'm going to right now make a decision that I want my paper to be in Times New Roman. You obviously can choose to do Arial as well. So I'm scrolling down so that I can find Times New Roman right there. And I want my entire paper to be size 12. While I've got everything selected and highlighted, I'm going to come over to this button that says line spacing. And right now it's probably in 1.15 because that's the Google default, but I need it to be at double spaced. So there it goes. The next thing I need to fix are the extra spaces that I have. Do you see how this right here is an extra space before my title? It needs to be deleted. Also, after my title is an extra space, that needs to be deleted. I'm going to check to make sure that this has been indented properly, and it has. Now what I'm doing is scrolling through so that I can get to my next paragraph and make sure I did do it right. See, there's no difference between my first paragraph and my second paragraph other than this indent. Here, I'm going to show you what would be incorrect. This, having this space here between paragraphs is incorrect, so get rid of all of that. I'm going through and making sure. Now, some of the time when you start messing with your paper, I knew it. The Works Cited page jumps up a little bit onto the next page. That cannot be there. That is not allowed. Works Cited has to start on its own separate page, so I'm just entering down until Works Cited is on its own page. I already know that after every period, I've only used one space, but if you think you need to check that, you can. A good way to check something big in your paper that you need to find fast is to do Control F, which opens up, this is what I must have typed before, where you can find, if I want to see all the times that I used a period, it will highlight all of those times. If I wanted to see all the times that I used a period with two spaces, right there, which doesn't matter, it'll highlight all of that. So if you're trying to look for that, you can do Control F. Now that the MLA requirements for font and formatting specs have been met, we're going to move on to the header. This is different from the heading. Thank you, MLA, for making it confusing. The header is going to have your last name and the page number on each page. So I'm going to demonstrate how to achieve this. Here in my paper, I need to put my header. And in Google, you have to go to Insert and scroll down until you see Header. Now I'm going to click that, and the mouse is automatically on the left-hand side, but I need it to be on the right-hand side. Do not just tab all the way over. That would be incorrect. What you need to do is change it to the right align, because see how it's on a left align right now? So I'm going to change it to right align, and now my mouse jumps over there. And I type in my last name. But I also need to have the page number. If you typed the page number, which is page one right here, page one will appear on all of your pages, because whatever you put in the header appears on all of the pages. And I don't want just page one on all of my pages, because some of them are page two and three. So the way to do that is to go to Insert again and go to Page Number. And it's giving me four options, and I need to select this one because I need the page to be in the upper right-hand corner, even on the first page. But the problem now is that it just says my last name and the page number, but there's no space in between. So make sure that you hit the space bar. And now I'm going to get out of this header, I'm just going to click off of it somewhere. So now it has the last name and the page number, last name and the page number, and it goes on and on. But we have a problem. I decided to make my paper Times New Roman. This header is in Arial, and it cannot be inconsistent. It's also in size 11. So you've got to make it size 12, and you've got to make it whatever if you chose Times New Roman. Okay, that is a very important step. You can pause the video and go ahead and do that right now. Now that you're done with your header, I'm going to show you some non-examples. In other words, these are the wrong way to do some things. And I'm showing you these because I keep seeing them over and over. If any of the things that I show you are happening in your paper, then you know that you've got to fix them. Take a look at this paper here. And something that I noticed right away is this big empty gap right here. For whatever reason, maybe when you were copying and pasting, something happened. You've got to notice that and hit backspace so that you can fix it. And I'm seeing another gap right here. So that needs to be fixed. You know what else is looking weird is this doesn't look like a tab. This looks like more than one tab. And in fact, I can look at that. I backspaced the whole way instead of using tab. You need to hit the tab button on your keyboard. That is the only correct way to indent on this type of paper. The other thing that I'm noticing are like just big, I did like lots of spaces for some reason between some of my sentences. That is going to take a very careful eye to find them, backspace, and fix them. And I can see even more, even down here. Remember, you have to tab. This one's not even enough spaces even if it were. So I'm going to get rid of this and tab it over. Whoops, went too far. You shouldn't have spaces in between your paragraphs like this, so you have to get rid of that as well. And then this next thing actually takes a really careful eye, but you will notice that when my mouse is right here, look at this is size 11, and this is size 11, but if you look really carefully, this is size 12. I've got some like various font sizes happening, and it's very hard to see. So the best way to fix font is all at once. If you do go back and for some reason add some extra sentences because you realize that you need more evidence or something like that, you're probably not going to realize that some of it is a different font size because it's so hard to see. So you're going to want to check your font by selecting all and really making sure that it's the right size. And the last thing I'll point out here is the title. It is bigger than the rest of, like the font size is bigger than the rest of the piece, which is not okay. And it's underlined, which is not okay. So everything needs to be size 12, including the title. And the title cannot be underlined or bold or italics or in quotation marks or anything like that. The other thing I'm noticing here is that I have spaces around my title. There shouldn't be any spaces. And so that when I do go to double space this, it's all spaced out with just one space between all of them. Now nearly all of your formatting should be up to snuff to meet the MLA requirements.